recording them or touring with them.
And yet,
if you were at those shows, I'm sorry.
The heart.
Apologize right now.
The hardcore true Alice Cooper fans all love these albums, right? Flesh and Fashion, Special Forces, Superficial Skin, and Dada, which is really one of my favorite albums.
Bizarre albums, just bizarre albums. I listen to it now, formerly warmer.
Yeah, it's, so Dada, and I personally don't know how to do my visual aid, because it's one of my favorite Alice Cooper albums of all time, because it is so different. It is so complex, it's so dark and complex, and yet it's kind of poppy and everything, it's so different. And so it's really interesting to me that you're at a point in your life where it's sort of like, I don't know what I'm doing anymore, but then you end up making such a thing that's so brilliant, I guess.
I think a lot of it was just purely instinct. Yeah. A lot of it was instinct. You know, you have to remember back then that you got into a rhythm of, that tour's over, we need another album. It didn't matter what shape I was in. I was going to make another album. You mean, if I had to do it from bed, I was going to make another album. And I wasn't incapacitated. I was just absolutely, you know, starting to lose memory, starting to lose everything. Because, you know, a bottle of whiskey, they don't do that. But I was never uncontrolled. I mean, I could sit down and write a lyric for you all day. I just wouldn't remember what I wrote. You know, and then when I sang it, I would go, oh yeah, I get this, okay. In the moment, it was fine. And so I think that's why it's cohesive. You know, a lot of it is cohesive. But I listened back to some of the songs like Tagger It.
Yeah.
You know, and that was the day my dad kind of returned to save my life.
Oh yeah, that's exactly
it. And I mean, I went, wow. What's going on inside of her, you know? But I really do enjoy those albums now when I listen to them because I realize that it was all subconscious. You know?
Well, okay, so will you ever play anything from Dada live? Because I don't think to this day anything is ever
played
live.
Let me see
the song. There's some good ones. There's, well, you can play Formerly Warmer.
Scarlet and Sheba.
Scarlet and Sheba's great. Yeah. I've always liked the Dyslexia.
Dyslexia, yeah. It's so funny because Bob Ezrin and I were talking about that song recently. We're doing another album right now. And Dyslexia was one of those songs I said, I would love to go back and find 15 songs off these albums and re-record them. Zorro's Ascent is one of my favorite songs.
Well, yeah. I mean, the other great example of that, of course, is Clones, which you did introduce recently to your live
right,
set.
Right.
If you listen to Clones now, I honestly think Clones would be a bigger hit today.
Yeah, at the time, I didn't like all the keyboards. But I was working with Roy Thomas Baker. If they ever do the life story of Nero, it's Roy Thomas Baker. Roy Thomas Baker would call me up, you know, like 3 in the morning and go, Anastasia, you seem to be handcuffed to my bed. Did I leave my Rolls Royce at your house? Since they picked up these 2 little girls and they handcuffed me to my bed and then took my wallet and my Rolls Royce. And as soon as I get out of here, I'll come in and finish the other. I got a call like that every night. He was the most decadent guy I've ever met in my life. He was Nero. I mean, he was absolutely, he was brilliant. When we did Flesh to Fashion, the guy was absolutely brilliant in the studio. You know, he knew exactly what he wanted.
And,
one of the great characters in rock.
Well, the characters, Special Forces, so one of my favorite Alice Cooper characters is on Special Forces. It's the whole degenerate field marshal.
That is the scariest character I've ever played.
Cross-dressing military, or cop, depending on which.
It looked like something from Vietnam.
Yeah.
That was like left over from Vietnam. The guy that didn't get the picture that was over. That was way into every, you know, probably eating scorpions or something. That character, I look at it now, and it's just frightening.
It was cross-dressing Rambo. That's pretty much what it
was. Yeah, it was only maybe more dangerous than Rambo. This,
yeah,
you know, he had chopsticks in his hair, you know, and there was like blood running out of his mouth. And honestly, that character on stage was, I used to throw ice picks. And my guitar player I could throw them and he'd have to dodge them. He'd have to, I made him dance. But I had like a bandolero of ice picks. And I was really good at it though. And he would be dancing all over the stage, and he'd be like, these are real ice picks. Now, I throw Chinese throwing knives now.
Okay.
Deadly with these things. I Fanning spoke thing.
Oh, yeah. I sent a demo from him.
Oh, no, I'll send it. Yeah. I have a picture of Marilyn Manson with an apple on his head.
Ooh, Alex. Any questions?